Hey guys, what's going on? So I've decided, after listening to this tune that I've been using for some of these Jimmy Herring licks, that I think I'm going to go through and just do it phrase by phrase so you guys can check out the whole solo. The solo itself would be too long to try to explain in one video, so I figure I'm just going to do that one phrase at a time. I've also got Bela Fleck's solo transcribed, and that thing is pretty cool. It's very interesting to take something that's on one instrument and then translate it to another. So anyhow, here is the first part of Jimmy Herring's solo. Now, keep in mind that the chords for this phrase of his solo is over an E chord for two measures, then F sharp 7 for two measures, D9 for two measures, and then back to E. Now that's not the feel, he's doing more of like a chicken picking kind of thing, or like a... Now, the thing that's cool about this is that he starts out in like a really fairly traditional kind of country approach. And then it gets into something slightly different. So I'm going to play it in time so you can hear it. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. So the interesting thing up here, I'll point out this first, is that he's bending the G sharp up to an A with the E string ringing. He's hitting the E string again. I don't know if it's on accident or intentional. He comes down with the phrase. So I'll go through the first part. It starts with the open E. Very straight up E major pentatonic. So that right there all of it straight down straight out of E major pentatonic from the G sharp. Okay, I'll do it one more time slowly. Now, if you are hearing this, there's a little kind of a hiccup note in between these lines. Especially, it's more noticeable here if you were to slow down the recording. You're going to hear that the open string, and that those notes are not in the key of E. I mean, in the E major pentatonic scale. But when it goes by so fast, you don't really pick up on it. So it's the same thing. Thank you. So check that out, and keep in mind when you're doing this, keep in mind the chord progression. To learn the lines and not consider the chords that are happening while the line is happening itself is, you're kind of getting only half of the value out of learning the line. So as this first line is happening, think E, right? F sharp 7. Oops. D7. Now as you do that, like with the last line at D9, you start to realize he's bending up to that A with the E on top, right? So that's basically like the top part of the D9 chord. There's that G sharp, so that's a 9, a D9, and a sharp 11. So what's interesting is you think about how does this scale work in relation to those chords. So when you're playing a D9 chord, and you're thinking E major pentatonic, what about thinking E major pentatonic and adding in the D? That might be something to think about as we start going through the solo is context, right? What's happening over the given chord? What chord is happening when the given phrase is happening? So anyhow, I hope you guys enjoy that, and take a listen to the recording if you haven't gotten a chance to. Get on iTunes or Amazon or something. It's an album that's very well worth buying, and the album before that too is very good as well. So you guys enjoy. I'll talk to you soon. Thanks.